Romero, he's an awesome dude, he's on your PC. He likes to make reviews for the movies you see. And if you want to sub his channel, take it from me. He makes us all right, totally surprised, and probably hates you. Romero Movie News, Romero Movie News, Romero Movie News, Romero Movie News, Romero Movie News.
Jackie Chan, touch my wiener.
So the teaser trailer for the Fantastic Four reboot just hit, and honestly, I don't really care. I don't know what it is with every studio that's not Marvel and Disney that has to try to make their comic book movies feel like a dark and gritty, realistic film. The Amazing Spider-Man film did this the first time around, and honestly, that's the reason why I disliked it so much. It's a comic book character, nothing about it has to be taken seriously unless you're trying to really highlight certain aspects. And I think that's the main issue with this Fantastic Four reboot. Of course, it's being directed by Josh Trank, who did Chronicle, which is an amazing film, and all around, if you haven't seen the Japanese film Akira, then I guess you would consider it a really good movie. All around, when I was watching this teaser, I had no emotion. Literally, no emotion. Everything about this teaser trailer felt so generic, like I've seen it 100 times before. Seriously, the voice narration in this sounds exactly like the voice narrations from Benedict Cumberbatch's Star Trek Into Darkness teaser and Andy Serkis' Force Awakens. Don't believe me? Listen to this comparison.
Have you felt it? You think your world is safe? How did we get this far?
Of course, this is like every generic voice narration in a teaser trailer, trying to make the trailer feel dark, gritty, and kind of important. It talks about power and mistakes and blah 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 blah. I've heard this 100 times before. Also, we get different shots of the main cast like Michael B. Jordan, Miles Teller, Kate Mara, and Jamie Bell. But where's Toby Kibble? No Dr. Doom in this? Okay, then I guess I can live with that, considering the fact that it's been confirmed that Dr. Doom is an internet blogger. I'm not even kidding, Google search it, that's what he is. So through the trailer we get this very dark tone, serious music, and this narration, and all this stuff about importance and whatnots, and it just really feels generic, and the CGI is borderline terrible. It's Spy Kids 3 bad.
What do you think, Grandpa?
Difficult.
That's right, Fantastic Four, your CGI is as bad as a Robert Rodriguez kids film. All around, this teaser trailer didn't do anything for me, and honestly, if you didn't notice it in the teaser trailer, the Thing is naked. Yes, he's naked, which means his rock-sized junk is probably out in the open. All around, this teaser trailer just looks like it's trying really hard to convince people that this Fantastic Four movie is going to be cool. It's not. Marvel itself did not give this film its blessing. Hell, in an issue of The Punisher, they killed the cast in a hotel room with a bazooka. That's how much Marvel does not approve of this new Fantastic Four reboot. I guess Marvel themselves know that the Fantastic Four has never been meant to be taken seriously, yet for some odd reason, Fox feels the need to get a director and make a movie that does. All around, I'm not really excited to watch this movie because I've never been interested in the Fantastic Four characters in general. Yeah, the first Fantastic Four movie's okay, but nothing else. I mean, especially considering the fact that we had this movie to put up with. But this film just really looks like it's going off the rails because it's taking itself way too seriously. The movie itself is taking itself way too seriously. Unlike the Ant-Man teaser trailer where I guess it knew it was taking itself too seriously, this one is actually trying to be a serious film. Oh god. So this has been my teaser trailer review for the Fantastic Four reboot. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you've seen the teaser trailer and what did you think of it? Were you intrigued? Were you kind of a little bit, you know, not even interested? Or did you actually like it? Which I highly doubt. Anyways, as always, I've been Romero for RMN and I've got your back, so you're on track. See you guys next time.